Hey guys, this is Mrs. Sticks taking over for Sticks today to bring you a closer look at the Seven Deadly Sins Grand Cross mobile RPG from Netmarble Corporation. This turn-based style game is available for both iOS and Android devices. Quite a few of you have been asking us to take a look at this game, and I'm more than happy to be the one that dives headfirst into this game as I've seen the first two seasons of the Seven Deadly Sins on Netflix. And I'm a huge fan! For those of you who have not yet seen this anime or read the manga, I'd strongly advise leaving now as there may be some spoilers for both of these for at least the first season and book. First things first, coming into the game, I can certainly say that you have a familiar group of characters from the anime that brought a warmth to this game that I had not come across before. With Meliodas' humor, Elizabeth's adorableness, and the rest of the story-rich sins, you're immediately thrust into the story of the Seven Deadly Sins, and I can with a certainty say that it follows the anime to a T thus far. However, there were a few characters I did not yet recognize. It felt like I was watching the anime all over again, only with the slow, non-essential parts thrown out. And the graphics, pretty much spot on for the anime. The only downside to the story being interwoven with this game is the fact I'd already seen the story, so there wasn't anything, I guess, fresh about it. And if you do play the game without being familiar with the anime or the manga, then I guess there'd be not much of a call to go delve into it aside from the game itself. As for the combat, it's a turn-based card game. You'll pick your team of three with a fourth laid back as a character to use in case one of your others die. Your cards can also be combined to create more powerful attacks if you put them side by side. You can either play the cards separating the like cards or lose a turn out of your three attempts by moving the card on your own. Each card, of course, is a skill that is unique to the character, like Meliodas' infamous counterattack, while Elizabeth uses Hawk for attacks. Your characters will also have a bar above their heads that will fill with each attack to reveal an ultimate move once it's fully charged. This attack will unleash a powerful smackdown on your foes. Overall, it requires a bit of pre-planning and thought on your part. There is also PvP that is unlocked at Chapter 4 in the story. There's also two types of PvP, one that relies on the gear of your characters and one that does not. Personally, I think it's great to be able to go into a fight and stand some type of chance, especially in a mobile game. If PvP isn't your cup of tea though, you can do story quests, daily quests, awakening quests, raids, and special event quests. Looking at the game beyond the combat, there is also the gacha system where you'll see Meliodas fight a demon to unlock a variety of character cards and other goodies. You can also go to the Boar Hat Tavern and craft a bit by cooking. You can also salvage equipment, talk to your beloved characters, and decorate your tavern. You can also change the appearance of your characters by changing their outfits, through unlocking them through PvP coins, gems, or winning them through the gacha-like systems. These outfits also give them stat boosts. Also, when going from town to town, it will allow you to control one of your characters depending upon where you are in the story to walk them around the area to your quest. That's just a nice little addition. So if you're looking for a great turn-based RPG that has a great story to it, this is the game for you. There's a few things they need to work on, like my game not randomly crashing, but it would appear I'm not alone in this with the most recent update that rolled out. I'm also curious how they'll go about releasing the story, if they'll try to time it with anime season release or what will occur, but I feel like I'm getting tiny spoilers by seeing some of the characters in my cards. Either way, I look forward to continuing on with my adventures from the Seven Deadly Sins. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
I ain't feeling lonely, and I wanna make this time to end the right. Fading into slowly, were those gonna lift me up this time? You were the only one who got me tripping up inside.